shame that as songwriters now, the Sweet have got a track record of their own. What are you going to keep writing stuff yourself?
Yeah, we've got a new album that we've just, as we were talking about in Munich, we've put it down, we've written all the tracks. We'll write everything from now on, and producer.
Selling all the millions of records you've sold, have you each made a lot of money out of all this?
Not really, no. Not a hell of a lot. I mean,
you couldn't retire,
considering we've sold about 28 million records, we should be millionaires. I mean, there must be £1 million somewhere between from 28 million records. We have to go out on the road and plough a hell of a lot of money into a stage act.
How much time do you spend on the road?
About 4 months a year, ideally. 74 was a bad year, so don't let's talk about it.
73 was ridiculous. We did 250 gigs.
Golly.
So that sort of...
And we spent a quarter of a million.
And spent a quarter of a million. But so we made our mind up to cut down and work for a period, you know...
When you're living like that, it must be hard to keep track of the money just to know how much you are spending, what you're building.
No, it's not.
Well, it's not, because we've got a guy working for us.
Now we've got one hell of an agent and, like...
Fella called Michael Anguish.
Good tour manager, good management now. They're all keeping tabs on where the money goes. We used to pay for things when we didn't realise it.
As Peter Townsend said, after 10 years of success, one becomes a millionaire very slowly. It ain't happened yet.
But you made quite a fan out of Pete Townsend, didn't you?
Yeah.
Was that because of your recording of My Generation?
No, it all happened before that. He came to a couple of gigs. We didn't even know he was at them.
Give him the full story. Anyway.
Yeah, give him the full story.
He came to a couple of gigs. He saw us... He asked us to do a gig with the Who, Charlton Football Ground. I got a kick in the throat, so we couldn't do it.
You got a kick in the throat?
Yeah.
At a concert?
A mugging? No, it was at a local...
In the street.
Local thing, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And it's just a private, it's just out for a drink.
The throat came up, and that was at that particular time, he asked us to do
Charlton
Football
Ground.
I'll tell
you how Generation came along. It came along the same way as Peppermint Twist did.
Twist, did you just decide to do that in the studio?
That was a track. We were doing it as part of our rock and roll medley.
It was a rock and roll medley.
Our rock and roll medley wasn't the traditional rock and roll medley where you just compile. We were looking for tracks that were obsolete. Like, how many people had heard Peppermint Twist or were performing it
two and a half, three years ago?
I mean, it was one of those tracks. It was a Joey D track. I mean, all right, a couple of us might well have heard of it, but not many of our fans would have heard
of it. Incidentally, we didn't know was a single in Australia.
Yeah,
so somebody happened to tell us it was number one.
They just
really?
A telex came through saying,
sure.
Oh, congratulations, number one in Australia with Peppermint Twist, and we went.
It wasn't a hit everywhere, it wasn't a single everywhere?
No, only Australia.
Do you get a new generation of fans, say, every...
No, I think in Europe-wise, they're very, very loyal. Whereas in England, they're very fickle. you know. But
you have
I mean,
to remember as well, they've grown up with us. I mean, when they were 14 and they were digging us then, you know, they're 18 now, they can appreciate the progression in the music.
Now on Countdown, we've got the Sweet with us, and I'd like to present them with two of the gold records of two of the number one hits in Australia. The first was Ballroom Blitz, Brian, which...
I'll take this one, because I'm going to introduce it.
Yeah, right. Oh. Which was really fantastic as far as the single was concerned, and was the first biggie here. And then straight after that was Peppermint Twist, so Mick, if you take
Thank
that
you
one
very
as well.
Much.
Congratulations.
On behalf of the group.
I know.
Hold on, I believe in a week's time that Fox on the Run is due for a gold record as well.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, nice one.
So that's really
stuff.
Three, not two.
So we'll have half each then, Andy.
Well, I think there's a gold record for Sweet's Hits as well, the album. So, Andy, you can have the album. All right.
No, thanks.
So, on behalf of...
On behalf of us all, we'd like to say thank you for everyone who made it all possible.
And I believe we're going to have a listen to Ballroom Blitz.